Hey folks, Jim Thomas here, Fitness Management and Consulting, and I appreciate you being at the channel today. And for those of you that have not yet done so, hey, please hit the subscribe button. We appreciate it. And then also, if you enjoy the content that is provided, you know, hit that like button as well. Now, our topic for you today, it's 8 habits of gym salespeople that are highly accountable. And these are the ones that are going to produce the most. And we can even say gym management, you know, that's highly accountable. You can take these same strategies and really put it into any, you know, kind of a job title. So number one on our list is they take responsibility. You know, it's never the customer's fault. It's never somebody else's fault. Hey, I accept full responsibility. I mean, it could be, you know, maybe you're late for work and maybe there was an accident. Hey, I'm not going to blame the accident. I accept full responsibility. You know, you could have left earlier, right? Okay, so get in the habit of accepting full responsibility. And this is a powerful thing, too, when you're dealing with your customers. Mary, I understand. I take full responsibility for that. So take responsibility. Number two, they don't make excuses. You know, they don't put their success in somebody else's hands. You know, it's a no excuse zone. Okay, if it is to be, it's up to me. Okay, so you're entering a no excuse zone, you know, when you're talking with somebody who has a high level of accountability. Number three, as I mentioned a moment ago, they get to work on time. I mean, people that are really accountable, you know, they get there early and they're probably the last ones to leave. You know, and one of the ways that I look at being on time, you know, to me, it's the very first promise that you make. And if that promise is broken, you know, has a tendency to make me think other promises might be broken. So, you know, people that are highly accountable, they get to work on time. And most of those folks are kind of hanging around afterwards as well. Okay. Number four on our list, you know, people that are accountable, they control their own fate. And what I mean by that is they don't put their success in somebody else's hands. Their success is in their hands, no matter what is going on. No matter if it's everything that's gone on in 2020 or other things that happen, they put success in their own hands. If it is to be, it's up to me. So they control their own fate. Number five on our list is people that are highly accountable. They own their own feelings. They own their own feelings. And they do not let the negative enter into this. And what they do is they look at the positive. You know, they look at what's good. They look at possible solutions. You know, as the saying goes, you know, the glass is half full, right? Not half empty. So they own their feelings. There's no negativity. They're looking at the positives and they're looking for solutions. Because as I said many times, you know, we can just get just about anybody to tell you what's wrong. That's not a hard thing to do. It's focus on the solutions. So own these feelings and make sure, you know, that they're positive solutions. Next on our list, they manage expectations. They manage expectations. And what I mean by that is they're real clear on what needs to be done. They're real clear on desired outcomes. And part of that's because they, you know, they track things daily, they write a plan of action. You know, there's things that kind of go behind this, but they're real clear on what the desired outcomes are. There's nothing vague about it. Okay. Next on our list is they collaborate. In other words, people that are highly accountable, they use every resource around them to have success. Every resource you can think of. They're not trying to go it alone. Okay. You know, wherever they can get help, they're going to try to get it because they're accountable. Success is not optional. Okay. And then finally on our list, they don't expect praise. You know, folks that are highly accountable, you know, these top folks in sales and management and other positions, they're not looking for praise, okay? They want to get the job done, okay? And in part, you know, we're working to help make other people better. So take a look at these steps. Take a look at these tips. Where do you fall into this? These are some difficult things for folks. You know, I talk to folks all the time that, you know, say, hey, you know, I've got the attitude, I'm working hard, I'm doing these things, but they're not necessarily choosing to be accountable. If something goes wrong, oh, well, here's somebody over here that caused that to go wrong. This is essentially your process. What is your process to maintain a high level of accountability? And maybe one thing I might add to this that can it can be the platform this whole thing sits on is understand your powerful why. Know why you're doing this. What's your super objective? What's the reason you're doing it? You know, let all of this sit on top of that, and that can help give you that direction and that daily discipline to stay true to these various steps. So folks, my name is Jim Thomas. My company is Fitness Management and Consulting. If you enjoy the content that I provide, you know, please hit that like button below, and we'll look forward to chatting with you real soon.